Hello, my name is Huang Yanran and you could call me Wenny. Here is my audio about news on New Yorker and thanks for listening. The truth about selfie culture. The selfie, that ubiquitous symbol of millennial navel gazing, is often used as exhibit A in the argument by older generations that millennials are self-absorbed, narcissistic and entitled. But is that really the whole picture? A new video by Aaron Breisler and Tim Hawson, the latest installment in our obsession series, takes another tag, placing this symbol of millennial narcissism in a larger cultural story. Will Storr, the author of Selfie, How We Became So Self-Obsessed and What It's Doing to Us, traces self-culture to the self-esteem movement. This crazy idea came about in the late 80s and early 90s that, in order to free ourselves of all these social problems, everything from drug abuse to teenage pregnancy, we just had to believe we were special and amazing, Storr says. Instead, this philosophy filtered into a parenting style that created impossible expectations for the children who were raised with it. When they failed to meet these expectations over and over again, they entered this state of despair that can manifest in all kinds of self-destructive behaviors, Storr says. One particular moment in the video captures the tension between a selfish presentation of perfection and the precarious sense of self underneath. A group of women in San Francisco's Dolores Park takes exuberant selfies, looking happy and carefree. But when asked, one of the women admits with unmistakable sadness that Instagram only worsened her feelings of inadequacy. Ultimately, for me, I think it's not that healthy.